Walmart. I use the Walmart grocery pickup service like how I normally do, and I got a major substitution deal going on over here with the cheese, which I will show you in a second. Normally I set all the groceries up on my table over here, but as you can see, it's over here in the kitchen because these guys like will not stay out of it. They're like ripping into the boxes and stuff. So anyway, I'll just start off over here. Got 2 pounds of strawberries and some spinach. The spinach is for salads and stuff that we're gonna have this week. And then some cilantro, because I'm going to make a cilantro lime rice and pico de gallo. So I got 2 of the cilantros. Over here, I think this is 3 pounds of grapes. They just go through those. And then here is everything for the pico de gallo. So you need a red onion, some tomatoes. Tomatoes are kind of small, but I do have some tomatoes in the fridge that I can add to the pico to kind of fill it in a little bit more. Some jalapenos to go with the pico de gallo. Some green onions, that is for the baked potatoes. 2 cucumbers for snacking and salads. And then a green bell pepper that is for some Philly cheesesteak sliders, which that is the meat right there that I use for the Philly cheesesteak. So I'll just make that for lunch one day, and then I'll have it over, you know, a few days. I'll get a few lunches out of that. I also picked up some of these honey breast tenders. So I kind of forgot about these, to be honest. These are so good. I got some a few weeks ago and the babies just ate them up. They loved them. And so I just thought, you know what, I'll grab some more. Over here, I got some more minced garlic. I usually use that in a lot of different recipes. And then I needed some onion powder. I'm gonna make some of my own taco seasoning. So I have everything else except for onion powder. I bought some lime juice. There it is. And that is gonna be for the cilantro lime rice. I find it's easier just to get the juice like that in the container. I used to buy the limes and, you know, juice them myself. But sometimes you don't get a lot of juice out of it. So anyway, got that. Also got some pinto beans, that is for the burrito bowls that we're gonna have this week. Some black olives, we're gonna have a salad night one night, so the husband wanted some black olives, and then he also wanted some of these real bacon pieces to put on his salad. Also got some Italian dressing that is for marinating wings. And I have wings on our meal plan. For some reason, I forget to order this, so I got 2 just to have one back up in the pantry. Also, we're gonna have spaghetti this week with some meatballs. So just needed some spaghetti sauce. And then I also got some original kettle chips. That's the kind I like. The husband really likes these Pringles, the wavy roasted, fire roasted jalapeno. I got those from last week and he really liked those. Also 2 boxes of yogurt that'll go in the freezer for the boys. And then I also got some pancake mix. Again, as you can see, they like ripped into it. So, which is fine because I have a container that I will store that in. 2 gallons of milk. We already had to get into that. And then I'm kind of a little crazy when it comes to cleaning gloves. I like to have them. I usually use mine pretty hard. So I'll like poke a hole in them or something from scrubbing something. Anyway, I have to have a backup. So that's my backup. And then here's the cheeses. Okay, so I'm trying to remember. Okay, so I guess I'll start here. I got some just sharp cheddar cheese for sandwiches. And then I got some provolone cheese that is for the Philly cheesesteak sliders. And then I got some Parmesan cheese because that is for the recipe that I use for meatballs. It calls for like 1/4 cup of Parmesan cheese. And then I also sprinkle a little bit of the cheese in salad, like whenever I make Caesar salad. And so this is where it gets kind of weird. So I ordered also just some shredded extra sharp cheese for the baked potatoes. And then just like a 6 or an 8 ounce bag of Monterey Jack cheese, because I don't think I really have any cheese on hand actually, for burrito bowls. But they gave me a 2 pound bag of Colby and Monterey Jack cheese. So like, I don't know, I guess they were just completely out of Monterey Jack cheese. And so this was the best substitution, which this is a whole bunch. Like this is like a lot. So I'm thinking that I might freeze this cheese and just use this for like the baked potatoes and like the burrito bowls. So that's gonna live in my fridge for a while. And I also ordered just an 8 ounce bag of mozzarella cheese because I was going to make, with our spaghetti, I was gonna make, it's called garlic cheese bomb bread with the crescent rolls. So you just sprinkle a little bit of mozzarella cheese inside of a crescent roll, you roll it up and you bake it, and then you just brush it with a little bit of butter. And you know, it's yummy and everyone really likes those. I've made this before in the past, but they gave me a pound of mozzarella cheese. So I have a whole bunch of cheese on hand. Typically I'll order, again, you know, a size like this, and it'll live in our fridge for, you know, 2 weeks or whatever, and we'll add it to different dinners, but a whole lot of cheese. So again, we'll be good on cheese for a while, and maybe I'll freeze some of it. I am interested, and some of you guys might be able to help me do this or figure this out. I am interested in maybe buying my cheese from Costco, because I've bought Great Value cheese forever, so it's fine. Costco, their cheese is about the same price, but I've never tried it, so maybe it's better quality. I'm not as big of a fan of having like so much cheese on hand where I have to freeze it, but I know people do, so you know, let me know in the comments down below if you guys get your cheese from Costco and how you store it and all that stuff. So anyway, I won't have to buy any for a while, like I mentioned. So that's for a future Costco trip, maybe. Also got some eggs just for random things. And then some more of this French bread for sandwiches. I have some chicken salad left in the fridge, so I'm gonna make a sandwich today and have that for lunch. And then some wheat bread over here for sandwiches as well. But anyway, that's everything I picked up today. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.